Hello all, I'm very happy to welcome you all to my channel for the English series which I'm doing completely for my other language friends. And today in this video also we are going to see about the Change Your Thinking series 1, which will change your life. Okay, so today I'm going to give start with a story which will definitely make you think at the end of this series. Okay, let's begin with the story. Once upon a time, there was a woodcutter. Okay, so he was seeking for a good job to a timber merchant, and finally he found a job to the timber merchant, and that pay and the work conditions, everything was good in that, and the woodcutter was very happy, as we also will do like that, right? So if we get job, we'll be very happy and we'll be feeling like we have to give the 100% of ours to that job. So similarly, the woodcutter also chosen to be like that. He wants to bring some much numbers of trees collecting every day to the timber merchant, and he did that also. The next day of his joining, he went to the forest or the place where he wanted to cut down the trees. He took his axe and he went to the forest, and he brought some 18 numbers of trees to the timber merchant, and the timber merchant was very happy about the woodcutter employee. He is doing his best out of it. And the next day passes away. Every day the woodcutter is putting the most effective effort of his, but he couldn't make that done with 18 number of trees each by each every day, because the next day the woodcutter can bring some 17 number of trees only, and the next day 16 number of trees, but he is putting more efforts than the first day. But why he couldn't do that? And he himself got a question in him, and he went to the timber merchant, apologized for his mistakes. Sorry sir, I am getting down nowadays. I don't know, I am putting all my efforts in cutting down the trees, but I couldn't make that possible as I did in the first day. Sorry for that, like that. To the timber merchant he is telling, okay. So the timber merchant is raising a question to him. When was the last time you sharpened your axe? I'll repeat the question. See, when was the last time you sharpened your axe? And the woodcutter replied, sharpening? I'm very busy on cutting down the tree, sir. I don't have any time to sharpen my axe. See, this is how we also behave in our life, running towards our family, running on our problems, running on things which we even don't want, you know. We even not giving enough time for ourselves. We are not analyzing what is happening inside us, either we are with inner peace or not, or we are lagging out of it or not. We are not thinking about us even. So this story will definitely make you think what we have to do, why we are lagging out of failures, why we can't able to achieve success in the short period of time. You know why? This is the reason. We all are forgetting to sharpen our brain, to be sharp, because we are running, and in this world we are very busy without knowing each other. We are very much busy on mobile phones and things which we even doesn't matter for our life. You know what to do now? We have to be patient and hold our life for a minute and give some meditations or give some time for God, learn and grow even. So this will definitely make your success to be within, closer to you. Unless if you are not going to think what you are doing exactly today in this world, then how come your success will be in your hands? So this is why we are lagging out of success, and our failures are all in our way. So in this series we have learned things like we have to be sharp enough every time, and we have to analyze ourselves every once whether we are in the proper way or path towards where we wanted to reach. In the mid of the way towards our goal, definitely we may distracted and we may go to some other work or job which is unnecessary for our destiny. So if you are in that kind of situations now, please come back and put your path towards your destiny, which is the right thing what you have to do, and never ever forget to be sharp enough.